Mr. Sandesh Pare. I am currently working as an assistant professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. And in this session, we are going to focus the list data type in the Python. Okay. So before going to implement this list, we will check what will be the learning outcome. Okay. So at the end of this video, you will be able to perform all the operations related to the list data type. Okay. So let's start to implement the list data type. Okay. So for that, what we'll do is that suppose we'll take the list of the numbers. Okay. For that, I will use the nums variable, and in that I will give you the list. I will assign the list to this one. Okay. And for the list, the square brackets is used. Okay. To denote that it is the list. Okay. And here I will pass the numbers, that is 25, let's say 12, any random numbers. Okay. So 36 comma 95 comma 14. Okay. So this is my list of the integer numbers. So yes, it is get created. If you want to check the values of this list, then you just have to specify its name, and the output is displayed on the screen. Okay. So square brackets are mandatory to indicate that this is the list. And after that, if you want to perform any operation related to this one, this list one, okay, so there are techniques. Suppose these numbers are stored in the indexing format, right? If you want to fetch any one of the number, okay, then you have to pass the index there, and it will give you the exact number. Okay. And it is starting from the zero. Okay. So let's say nums of zero. Okay. It is 25. Okay. So in this fashion, you can use the indexing to fetch, to access any particular number. Okay. And you can specify the negative indexing also. Okay. Let's say nums of minus 1. Okay. Let's check what is the output. As you can see, the 14 is the output. Okay. Why? Because whenever you specify the negative index there, okay, it will start traversing from the last one. Okay. And it will start from the first one. Okay. Minus 0 is not there. Okay. So you will start from the minus 1. And obviously, minus 2 is 95, minus 3 is 36, in this fashion. Okay. And instead of this positive and negative indexing number, okay, you can specify the range also in the indexing. Okay. So let's say nums of okay, here are 0 to 4 indexing is there. Okay. I will say 2 is the starting index, and I want up to the 3. Okay. So as you can see, the output is 36. Okay. It will exclude that third index. Okay. It will start from the okay. For your confirmation, we'll take one more example. So nums of okay, instead of this one, and again 3. Okay. So 12 comma 36. Okay. So the index at the third location, okay, it will get excluded here. Okay, that is 95. It will start from the starting index, but it will exclude the last index one. Okay. After that, we will just want to tell you that it is not limited to the integer values only. Okay. So instead of this integer numbers, if you want to give the strings as the items in the list, then you may do it. Okay. So let's implement that one. But before going to that, I just want to tell you that when you specify the range here, okay, when using the indexing, if you did not mention the sum of the number, then it will not create any chaos. Okay. For example, nums of okay. So I will start from the second index, and I will not specify the end of this sublist. Okay. So if you did not specify the end of this sublist, then it will go up to the end of the list. Okay. Let's check. As you can see, it will start from the 36 and it will go up to the 14. That is the last item in the list. Okay. And in reverse fashion also it will work. Okay. If you did not specify the starting of the sublist, then it will start from the start by defaultly. Okay. Let's check by doing so. Now I will not mention the starting of this list. Okay. I will just tell the end point. then the value, you can see that it will start from the first, that is 0th index, that is 25, 12 and 36. Okay, it will exclude the third index, so it will end up to the 36. Okay, so now instead of the these integer numbers, we will try to give the strings there. Okay, I will use the another one list here. So let's say names, and here I will specify the, suppose ABC is my first string, PQR is my second string, right, and third string is XYZ. Okay, so it will work, no any problem. Okay, if you want to check the values, then you just have to pass this number. Okay, so as you can see in the output, the ABC, PQR, XYZ are the values. Okay, and it is not mandatory to have all the similar type of data in the list. Okay, let's cross verify this statement. Okay, let's implement the values is equal to. Okay, what I will do is that I will pass the mixture of all the data types. Okay, for example, I will say 9.5 and I will say the string JKL. Okay, and I will pass one integer L. Okay, 25, right? So see, it works. Let's cross verify the contents of the values. You can see it. Okay, so multiple type of data is supported in this one. Okay, and one more thing, you can create the list using the list. Okay, this statement is very complex, but let's focus on this one. I will say miscellaneous is equal to. Okay, so I will use all the numbers and names. Okay, numbers contains the only integer values, and names contain the string values. Okay, so I will specify here nums comma names. Okay, so see, it is creating the error. Why? Because suppose, oh, I provided there a curly bracket instead of the square bracket. Okay, so it was my mistake. Names. Okay, nums comma names, right? It should work now. Okay, it worked. As you can see, the list is containing the two sub list there. Okay, and I want to tell you one thing, that suppose let's say nums is a dot. Okay, so these are various functions which are related to the list is given there. Okay, for example, append and close, copy, count, extend, these are some various methods which are provided for the list. Okay, you can have a look on that. Okay, so I just want to ask one thing, that what is mutability, and is the list data type is mutable, and why? Just think and answer. So mutability is the quality in which it allows, okay, the programmers to manipulate the particular data. Okay, and yes, the list is the mutable data type. Okay, because programmer can update the values. Okay, as you just we have seen that methods. Okay, in the list. Okay, so what is that methods are obviously this append. Okay, you can append the values. Okay, you can extend it. Okay, and you can remove it. It means you can make the changes in the list data type. Okay, so that's why this is the mutable type of the data type. Okay, so let's make a changes there. Okay, I will use the first append method here. Okay, and I will use the 45 number. Okay, so any random number. Okay, so I will append this number. See, it works, and I just want to check this nums again, and 45 is get appended at the end. Okay, as you can see on the screen. And if you want use one more method, that is insert method is also there. Okay, so append is also adding the elements, and insert is also adding the elements, but what is the difference between them is that you just pass the number when using the append, but when you use the insert, okay, you have to pass the index number where you want to insert that number. Okay, this is the index, second index, I want to add this value, and my value is 77. Let's Okay, so yes, it worked, and I just want to check again the values of the nums. You can see at the second index the 77 is get inserted. So in this fashion you can make the changes in this list. Okay, if you want to use the remove method, okay, let's say remove, I just want to remove 36, let's say. Okay, I just want to remove this 36, and yes, it worked. And after that I want to check 36 is removed from this one, and again instead of the remove there is one more method, that is the pop method. Okay, nums dot pop, and instead of this number, okay, here in the pop function you have to specify the index number. Okay, so let's say 1. Okay, so yes, it is popped. So in this fashion you can make the changes in the list. So that's why it is called as the mutable type of the data type. So this makes the list data type different from the other data types. Okay, so these are some references I used to make this video. Thank you.